Sir, please start.
Good morning, all the viewers, and good morning, all the principals, PGTs, TGTs, and all the students of Model School family. This is Muhammad Riyazuddin, principal, Telangana Model School, Jarasangam from Sangareddy district, and I am a subject coordinator for the second year commerce. And already we covered many topics in the second year. Now we are going to start the partnership accounts. In that we have admission of a partner and retirement of a partner. Now this webinar session is going to be handled by the V. Premlata, PGT Commerce from TSMS Bullaram, Jinnaram Mandal, Sangareddy district. Already you all aware about the madam, and in this session, this is the first session from the admission of a partner topic. And dear student, this is very important topic, and this is a 20 marks compulsory question in your board exam. And in this today's session, we used to learn about the revaluation account and preparation of goodwill and capital and profit sharing ratios and reasons for admission of a partner. So without wasting time, I handed over to V. Premlata madam to handle the session. Please, madam.
A wonderful good morning to all the principals, teachers, viewers, and students. I am V. Premlata, PGT Commerce from TSMS Bullaram, Jinnaram. Today, I'm here to take on the topic admission of a partner for intermediate second year students. Children, this is a very important chapter, as the weightage for this chapter in your final exams is for 20 marks. So you'll be getting a 20 marks problem from this chapter, as well as a 2 marks problem on profit sharing ratio, how to calculate profit sharing ratio. So total 22 marks you will be getting from this chapter. So you just go through whatever we discuss, and if at all you have any doubt, children, you can write it in the comment box, children. Okay. The subject coordinator for intermediate second year accountancy and commerce is Mr. Riyazuddin sir, principal, TSMS Jarasangam. Now, admission of a partner. From this chapter, after completing, what you will be learning? What are the learning outcomes? You will be learning calculation of new profit sharing ratio, how to calculate new profit sharing ratio, revaluation of assets and liabilities, adjustment of accumulated profits and losses and reserves, goodwill and accounting treatment, accounting of capital of new partner, adjustment of old partner's capital on the basis of new profit sharing ratio, and practical problems. Okay, so in this session you will be having only calculation of new profit sharing ratio and a specimen of revaluation account we will be discussing. Practical problems will be discussed from second session onwards, children. Now, why admission of a partner? Why we need to admit a partner already to overcome the demerits of sole proprietorship? We are doing partnership firm. Already there are existing partners. Then again, why they want to admit a new partner? See, whenever the old partners want to supplement their existing resources, a new partner may be admitted for the expansion of their business. So, to supplement their resources and to expand their business, the old partners want to admit a new partner. So if a new partner is admitted into the business, what he will be bringing along with him? He will be bringing capital. Not only capital, his skills. If at all he is having any managerial skills, that also can be utilized for the business. Yes or no? So to use capital or to use his managerial skills or both, the new partner is admitted into the business. Okay, when an existing partnership firm requires additional capital or managerial help or both to expand their business, then a new partner is admitted into the business. Okay, now admitting a new partner, already there are existing partners, already partners are there. Okay, so when they want to admit a new partner can directly enter into the business. See, like we go to anyone's house, we knock the door or we ring the bell. Then when they give permission, then only we enter into their house. It's not like that. even if we know them, we don't directly enter into their house. Here also same way. If a new partner is admitted into the business, all the partners should agree. That means they should give their consent to admit the new partner into the partnership business. See, as per Partnership Act 1932, a new partner can be admitted into partnership business with the consent of all the partners. If all the partners are giving consent, then only a new partner can be admitted into the business. Okay, that means all partners should agree. All the old partners should agree to admit a new partner into the partnership firm. Okay, a new person may be admitted into partnership with the consent of all the partners. Okay, when a new partner is admitted into the partnership firm, he will be acquiring two rights. Two rights will be given to the partner, whoever is being admitted into the partnership firm. One is, he will be getting right in the share of all the assets of the company. Not only that, right to share the profits of the partnership firm. So the profits also, he will be having right. In the assets of the company also, he will be having right. Okay. Since the share of profit given to the new partner may be given by any one of the existing partner or by all the partners. So now he is going to take share in the future profits. This share either can be given by only one partner or it can be given by all the existing partners. That is, he may be getting share from only one partner. One partner will give his share, other partners will keep silent, that they will not give any share. If not, in the other case, everybody will be giving share to the new partner. Either way, anything can happen. Either one or everyone can give share in the profits to the new partner. Okay. And even he will be having right in the assets of the company. Now, whatever rights the existing partners are having, even the new partner also will be having the same rights on the assets of the firm. And he will be getting share in the future profits also. Okay. Is it clear, children, till here? A new partner is admitted for capital or for his managerial skills or both. And he will be admitted only with the consent of the existing partners. After getting admitted, the new partner will be acquiring two rights. One right is share in the assets of the partnership firm, and the second right is to share the profits of the partnership firm. So this share, either only one partner will be giving or he will be getting it from all the existing partners. Okay. Now, since a new partner acquires a share in the future profits of the firm, the existing partners lose. That means they are going to sacrifice. Till now, 100 rupees is shared only between two partners. Let us say only two partners are there, A and B. Now they admitted C into the business. Now A and B are sharing 100 rupees, like we say, equally. That is 1 by 2, 1 by 2. Now a new partner is admitted. Then from this half, A will be giving some share to new partner and B also will be giving some share to new partner. Yes or no? That means they are going to sacrifice something. And who is going to gain from this sacrifice? The new partner is going to gain from this sacrifice. Okay. The partner on admission brings in his or share of capital. Okay. See, the old partners are sacrificing something for admitting a new partner. Then while sacrificing, why they will admit someone? There should be some benefit even for the new existing partners, no? Then why they are admitting? Why they will be admitting? Because the new partner, when he is admitted into the business, what he will be bringing with him? He will be bringing capital. And not only that, he will be bringing some additional amount also, that is called as premium. Or this premium is also called as goodwill. Why he will be bringing all this? In order to compensate sacrifices made by the existing partners. The existing partners are sacrificing, like A and B are sacrificing, no? From half, they are giving some share to Mr. C. That means they are sacrificing something. And the new partner who admitted into the business, he is gaining something, no? So for this sacrifices, whatever the old partners are doing, the new partner will bring his share of capital as well as an additional amount called premium, that is goodwill. Already in first year you studied, children, what is goodwill? Goodwill is nothing but the good reputation of the company in the market. Okay, like it could be their nature of the business, it could be the size of the business, it could be the product what they are producing in the market, the good satisfaction of the customers, it is also goodwill, no? Or their relationship with everybody in the market, the customers, debtors, bankers, whatever it is, they have a very good reputation in the business. Okay, so that is called as goodwill. Okay, it is an intangible asset. We cannot see it, we cannot touch it, but we can experience it, no? So for this goodwill, the new partner will be paying some amount. For this reputation, the new partner will be paying some amount called as premium. Now, why he has to pay something? See, children, the old partners, it is not like that the goodwill is made for one day or 2 days, you will achieve that goodwill, no? It will take a lot of hard work. They could have been done a lot of hard work. It could have been taken many years to reach that level, to get that name in the market, to get that good name in the market. So they have done the hard work. Now it is time to eat the fruits. Now the new partner, whoever is admitted into the business, seeing that fruits only, he is admitted. Now just tell me, if at all that company is in losses, it is not having good name in the market, anybody will admit into that company? Anybody will is interested to do business with that company? No one will join investing some amount, no? So because of the goodwill only, the new partner is also attracted towards the business. So he will be paying some amount, additional amount called as premium for this goodwill. Okay, this goodwill will be shared among the old partners. Okay, whatever compensation he is giving for the existing partners, what compensation, why he is compensating them? Because they are losing their share of profits. Okay, and this good name, whatever is there for them in the business, in the market also, for that also he will be paying some amount called as goodwill. Now, simply with an illustration, same thing can be understood here. Let us say XYZ is a partnership firm. Here, old partners, ABC, they admitted a new partner, let us say D, into the business. Already, this old partners are sharing this profits in their old profit sharing ratio. Already they are sharing. Whenever a new partner is admitted into this business, this from this whole share, they have to give some part of the share to the new partner, whoever is admitted into the business. So this share either is given by only one person, or this share is given by everybody. Everybody will give from their share little to the new partner, or only one partner only will give from his share to the new partner. It could be anything. So for taking share and the, for the sacrifices what they are doing for by giving their share, what this new partner is doing? He is paying some amount, or he is bringing some amount as capital to the business, and whatever good name they are having in the market, for that he is paying some amount as goodwill, premium amount called as goodwill. Okay, admission of partner referred to entering a new partner or partners in the partnership firm for the share of profit by paying off his share of firm's goodwill and capital. In simple words, if we understand, the old partners will be sacrificing something and the new partner will be gaining something. For whatever sacrifice they are making, the new partner will be paying them as a goodwill, and he will also bring some amount as capital to the business. Okay, so in the future profits, he will also get some share. He will also get some share in the future profits. So whenever a new partner is admitted into the business, the following adjustments are to be made in the books of accounts. Okay, the following adjustments should be made whenever a new partner is admitted. That is calculation of new profit sharing ratio. In the next slides, we will be discussing in depth regarding this calculation of new profit sharing ratio. See, calculation of new profit sharing ratio, why they need to calculate again new profit sharing ratio? Whenever a new partner is admitted into the business, the existing partners are giving some part of their share. Yes, they are sacrificing, and the new one, whoever is coming, he is going to gain. So their profit sharing ratios will be changing. Definitely it will change. So we need to calculate their new profit sharing ratio for to share for their future profits, whatever they are going to share in their future profits, for that we need to calculate their new profit sharing ratio. So new profit sharing ratio will be changed whenever a new partner is admitted into the business. Next, revaluation of assets and liabilities. The value of assets and liabilities should be revalued, because whenever a new partner is admitted into the business, the old partners should settle everything. Like the assets are purchased long back, liabilities could be outstanding, they are pending or paid, not paid, recovered, not recovered, anything. So assets and liabilities, there could be some changes. So what the old partners should do, they should revalue them, so that the new partner who is admitted into the business, he will not gain or he will not lose anything. He will not have any effect because of this assets and liabilities, changes in the assets and liabilities. For that reason, before admitting any partner into the firm, they have to revalue everything. Okay. So revaluation of assets and liabilities is done whenever a new partner is admitted into the business. Now, accounting treatment of goodwill. So valuation of goodwill and its accounting treatment, it depends upon many factors, but the goodwill also, how we need to treatment, because in admission of a partner, goodwill plays a very key important role. Okay. Because of this goodwill only, we know that new partner is admitted into the business. If there is no good name, no one is going to be admitted. No one will show interest in admitting into the business. No. So the accounting treatment of goodwill also plays a very key important role when we are talking about partnership business. Next, the distribution of reserves and undistributed profits and losses. Like any other business organization, even partnership firm also, some amount is kept as a reserve. Okay, some from profits, they keep some amount as reserve. Okay, so this reserve, it belongs to old partners. So whenever a new partner is admitted into the business, this reserve should be distributed among the old partners. So this also should be calculated. And even undistributed profits and losses also, if at all anything is there, that also need to be transferred to old partners before a new partner is admitted into the business, because these are old reserve. Like, see, we also, what every month we get salary, we don't expend everything. No, what we do, we keep it as a side, because we don't know, everything is uncertain, life is uncertain, even business is also uncertain. One feature of business is uncertainty. Okay, you studied in first year, uncertainty is one of the main feature of a business. Okay, so when there is an uncertainty, definitely we need to keep some amount, because we don't know what is going to happen in future. So that amount that does not belong to any new partner, no? So that amount, before admitting a new partner, it should be distributed among the old partners. So if at all any profits which are also undistributed, that also should be distributed among the old partners. Then adjustment of capital in proportion to profit sharing ratio. So their capital accounts also will be changing, that also we need to calculate depending upon their profit sharing ratio. Okay. Now, calculation of new profit sharing ratio. I will be discussing about three situations, how to calculate a new profit sharing ratio. We will understand each and every topic scenario with an example. Okay. Calculation of new profit sharing ratio. When a new partner share of profit is given and nothing is mentioned in respect of profit sharing ratio of old partners. Okay, this is one situation where old partners, old profit sharing ratio is only mentioned, but their new profit sharing ratio is not mentioned, but new profit sharing ratio of new partner is given in the question. Okay, am I clear, children? Old partners, old profit sharing ratio is given. New profit sharing ratio is not given. New partners, new profit sharing ratio in the future profits is given. That's it. Then how to calculate? Understood now? When new partners share of profit is given and nothing is mentioned in respect of profit sharing ratio of old partners, then how to solve it? Okay. So here we have an example. A and B are partners sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 3:2. So A and B are old partners. They are sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 3:2. So their old profit sharing ratio, that is before admitting C into business, is 3:2. Now they admitted Mr. C into partnership firm for 1/5 share in future profits. So they admitted Mr. C into partnership firm. Who is admitted? Who is a new partner here? Mr. C. Or who is the incoming partner here? It is Mr. C. So Mr. C is the incoming partner or a new partner who is admitted into partnership firm for 1/5 share in future profits. So whatever profits they are going to earn in the future, Mr. C is going to get 1/5 share in the future profits. Okay. So here old partners, old profit sharing ratio is given. Mr. C is new partner. His new profit sharing ratio is given, which he is going to share for in their future profits. Now we need to calculate the new profit sharing ratio of A, B and C. Their new profit sharing ratio should be calculated. Okay. Now 3:2. This is a ratio. Now if you want to write that in fraction, how will we be writing? 3+2, how much children? 5. 3:2 means what? Out of 5 parts, 3 parts are given to A and 2 parts are given to B. Okay. Out of 5 parts, 3 parts are given to A and 2 parts are given to B. 3:2 means. Okay. So 3+2, 5. Out of 5, how many parts are given to A? 3 parts. And how many parts are given to B? It is 2 parts. Okay. So when we write in fraction, how you will write? This 3:2, how you will write in fraction? 3/5 and 2/5. Okay. Out of 5 parts, A is going to get 3 parts. And out of 5 parts, B is going to get 2 parts. So that is 3:2. 3:2. Is it clear? 3:2. How we need to write in fraction? Now they have admitted Mr. C for 1/5 share in their future profits. Now this is their old profit sharing ratio. Before admitting C, A and B shared whatever profit is there, they shared in 3:2 ratio, whatever they used to get profits in the old profit sharing ratio before admitting C. Now C is admitted for 1/5 share in future profits. Now let us say future profits are 1. Let us take this whole as 1. How much he is getting? 1/5 share. That means out of 5 parts, he is getting 1/5 share. One part he is getting. Out of 5 parts, he is getting 1 part. Okay. So who will be taking this remaining 4 parts? This remaining 4 parts should be distributed among A and B. Is it clear, children? If, again, I am explaining the question here. Here, old partners, old profit sharing ratio is given. And new partners, new profit sharing ratio is given, which he is going to share in the future profits. Then how to calculate new profit sharing ratio of A and B? This is the scenario here. This is the question. Okay. Old profit sharing ratio of old partners will be given. New profit sharing ratio of new partner will be given. Then how to calculate? In future profits, let us say the whole profit as 1. So if we subtract from 1, this new partner's share, 1 - 1/5, that is equal to 4/5. So if you are not having any maths background, children, you know how to calculate this. Like 1 means you have to think that it is 1/1. Okay. So we have to take the LCM for 1 and 5. 1 means 1/1, no? So denominator LCM we have to take. So what is the denominator here? 1/1 means 1 is a denominator. 1/5 means 5 is a denominator. So 1 and 5 LCM will be 5. This is LCM will be 5. So 1, how many times it will go in 5? 5 times. So 1 × 5. You have to multiply numerator into that 5. Minus 5, how many times it will go in 5? 1 time. So what is the numerator? 1. So 1 × 1. That is equal to 5 - 1/5. That is equal to 4/5. This 4/5, just you can understand with a small diagram here. Have you got this 4/5? Out of 5 parts, if we give 1 part to C, what is the remaining part? It is 1, 2, 3, 4 parts are remaining. So 4/5. If you are calculating like this, how you have to do? 1 minus 1 by 5 is equal to 4 by 5. How you will get 1 minus 1 by 5, 4 by 5, how you are getting? You will take LCM for 1 and 5, that is 1 into 5 minus 1 into 1 by 5, that is equal to 5 minus 1 by 5, that is equal to 4 by 5. If you want to understand in simple, this diagram explains you. Remaining ratio is equal to 4 by 5. From 5 parts, 1 part is given to C. So 4 parts should be distributed to A and B in their old profit sharing ratio. In this ratio, that is in this ratio, 3 is to 2 ratio, this 4 by 5 should be distributed to A and B. Then we will get new profit sharing ratio of A and B. Okay. So new profit sharing ratio of existing partners is equal to remaining profit share into old profit sharing ratio. Okay. How you will get, what is the formula? New profit sharing ratio of existing partners is equal to remaining profit share into old profit sharing ratio. Now we got in the last slide, we have seen what is the remaining ratio? It is 4 by 5. Out of 5, 1/5 part is given to C. So how much is remaining? 4 by 5 is remaining. So what is the old profit sharing ratio of A? 3 is to 2 means 3 by 5. Yes, 3 by 5. So new profit sharing ratio of A is equal to 4 by 5 into 3 by 5. 4 by 5 is the remaining profit sharing ratio. And 3 by 5 is A's old profit sharing ratio. Okay, old profit sharing ratio. So when you calculate, you will be getting 12 by 25. 4 threes are 12, 5 fives are 25. So new profit sharing ratio of A is 12 by 25. In the same way, we have to calculate new profit sharing ratio of B also. So new profit sharing ratio of B is equal to, what is the remaining ratio? Same, 4 by 5. So from 4 by 5, we are giving 3/5 part to A and we are giving 2/5 part to B. Okay. So remaining ratio is 4 by 5. What is the old profit sharing ratio of B? 3 is to 2 means what I told, how you'll write in fraction? 2 by 5. So 4 by 5 into 2 by 5, that is equal to 8 by 25. So new profit sharing ratio of B is 8 by 25. Now, new profit sharing ratio of C is 1 by 5. It is already given in the question. Yes, it is already given. No, like he is going to share 1/5 share in his future profits. So 1 by 5 is already given in the question. So then why we are multiplying with 5 by 5 here? See, whenever we want to write this as a ratio, like if you want to write it as 12 is to 8 is to 5 is the new profit sharing ratio, then all the denominators should be the same. Then only you can write it in the ratio form. But here denominator is 5. But here denominator is 25, denominator is 25, no? So what you should do? This denominator should be multiplied with a number so that your denominator will become 25. So if with what number you multiply, it becomes 25. 5 should be multiplied with 5. So 5 fives are 25. So when a denominator is multiplied, same number, it should be multiplied with the numerator also. So 5 ones are 5. So we are multiplying with 5 by 5. It means the same. 5 by 25 is equal to 1 by 5 only. See, when you reduce the value, for what it comes, 5 ones are 5, 5 is 25. So 1 by 5, it means the same. 1 by 5 or 5 by 25, it means the same. Okay. So now you can write this in a ratio form. So new profit sharing ratio of A, B and C is 12 is to 8 is to 5. Is it clear, children? So in this situation, old partners, old profit sharing ratio is given and new partners, new profit sharing ratio is given. Then how to calculate all the partners' new profit sharing ratio? How we will calculate? First, we have to get remaining ratio. How we will get remaining ratio? If we think the future profits of the company as one, of the firm as one. So from that, we know C's share. So we have to subtract that. 1 minus 1 by 5, that is equal to 4 by 5. That will be the remaining ratio. So if 1 by 5 is given to C, whatever is remaining, that should be distributed among A and B. So how we will distribute? On what basis we will distribute? We will distribute in their old profit sharing ratio. That is the reason 4 by 5 is distributed 3 by 5 to A and 2 by 5 to B. Then we will get new profit sharing ratio of A, B and C. That is 12 is to 8 is to 5. Is it clear, children? If you have any doubt, once again you go through the slide. Okay, next. In the second scenario, second situation, when a partner purchases a specific share of profit from the old partners, the following example clarifies. Now we will see in the second situation how to calculate a new profit sharing ratio. Like here, A and B, we will understand this with an example. A and B are partners sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 3 is to 2. Mr. C is admitted into partnership business for 1/5 share. Mr. C purchases his share as to 2 by 25th from A and 3 by 25th from B. Calculate new profit sharing ratio of A, B, C. Now, if you really understand the question, it is extension to for our first example. What we have understood in the previous slide, it is a little bit extension. In the previous slide, the question is stopped till business for 1/5 share. Okay, the question ends here. A and B are partners sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 3 is to 2. Mr. C is admitted into partnership business for 1/5 share. Calculate new profit sharing ratio in the first situation. Now the question is little bit extended. Now in this, what is the next step they are telling? Mr. C purchases his share as to 2 by 25th from A and 3 by 25th from B. Calculate new profit sharing ratio of A, B, C. This is A and B's old profit sharing ratio. That is 3 is to 2. That is 3 by 5 is old profit sharing ratio of A and 2 by 5 to B. Okay. So this is their old profit sharing ratio. Now we know C's new profit sharing ratio is 1 by 5. Okay. Till here, you know, if at all question comes till here, is asked in the exam, you know, in the previous example, how we solved calculating the remaining ratio, then we have to solve. But here, it little bit extension. What they are saying, this 1/5 share, how C is getting? C is getting this 1/5 share from A, 2 by 25th part. Like A is giving 2 by 25th part to C and B is giving 3 by 25th part to C. Is it clear now? Is it clear, children? Extension to the question, Mr. C purchases a share as to 2 by 25th from A and 3 by 25th from B. Calculate the new profit sharing ratio of A, B, C. So C, how he is getting this 1/5 share? A is giving 2 by 25th share. Like from this old profit sharing ratio, the C, Mr. A is giving 2/5 share to C. And B is giving 3 by 25th share from his share. Okay, from his share, he is giving 3 by 25th share to C. Now you have to calculate the new profit sharing ratio of AB. Okay, so what is the formula for new profit sharing ratio here? Old profit sharing ratio minus share of profit given to new partner. Okay, if they are having 10 rupees, we are telling that A is giving 2 rupees to C and B is giving 2 rupees to C. Then what will be the balance amount with the A? 10 minus 2, it will be 8. Same thing we are telling. He is having 3 by 5. His share is 3 by 5. Out of this share, he is giving 2 by 25 to C. Then whatever is remaining will be his remaining new ratio. So same thing we are doing here. Old profit sharing ratio minus share of profit given to new partner. So his old profit sharing ratio is 3 by 5. Okay, 3 is to 2, no? That is 3 by 5. 3 by 5 minus how much he is giving to C? He is giving 2 by 25. Now you have to calculate. Already we discussed in the previous slide, no? How to do when you have to take LCM for the denominators. 5 and 25. What is the LCM for 5 and 25, children? It will be 25. Okay. Then you have to calculate. 5, how many times it will go in 25? 5 fives are 25. So 5 into 3, you will get 15. Okay. 5 into, you have to multiply with the numerator. 5 into 3, 15. Minus 25, how many times it will go in 25? one time. So that again you have to multiply with the numerator. 1 into 2, that is equal to 2. Okay, so 15 minus 2 is equal to 13 by 25. So new profit sharing ratio of Mr. A is equal to 13 by 25. Now we will see the new profit sharing ratio of Mr. B. Okay, so what is the old profit sharing ratio of Mr. B? It is 2 by 5. Now how much he has given from this 2 by 5, how much he has given to Mr. C? He has given 3 by 25th part. From 2 by 5, he has given 3 by 25th part. So we have to subtract that. So 2 by 5 minus 3 by 25. Again, you have to calculate. How you will calculate? You have to take LCM for the denominator. So what is LCM for denominator? 5 and 25, LCM is 25 only. So 25. 5, how many times it will go in 25? It will go 5 5s are 25. So 5 into 2. 5 2s are 10. Minus 25, how many times it will go in 25? One time. So 1 into 3. You have to multiply with the numerator. 1 into 3. That is 3. So 10 minus 3 by 25 is equal to 7 by 25. So the new profit sharing ratio of Mr. B is 7 by 25. Next, new profit sharing ratio of Mr. C. It is already given in the question, no children. This 1 by 5. How he got this 1 by 5? This 2 by 5 is given from A, 3 by 25 is given from B. So his new profit sharing ratio of Mr. C is 1 by 5. I told no, whenever we want to write anything in the ratio form, your denominator should be the same. Here you have 5. So you have to make this denominator as 25. So you have to multiply with that number. If you multiply, which gives you 25. So if you multiply with 5, you will get 25. So when you are multiplying the denominator, same number, you have to multiply with the numerator also. So 5 by 5, that is equal to 5 by 25. So the new profit sharing ratio of A, B and C is 13 is to 7 is to 5. Is it clear, children? This is the second situation. In the first situation, what we have seen, A and B's old profit sharing ratio is given and C's new profit sharing ratio is given. What we have done there? We have calculated the remaining ratio and we have distributed that remaining ratio to A and B in the first situation. In the second situation, A and B, their old ratio is given and C's new share is given. And what they are telling, how he got that new share? He got from A some portion and from B some portion. So if we deduct whatever they have given, then their new profit sharing ratio we can find out. So this is the second situation. Now we will see in the third scenario, when old partners surrender a particular proportion of their share in favor of the new partner, the following example explains. Okay, now we will understand this with an example, children. Ram and Robert are partners sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 3:7:3. Okay, what is the old profit sharing ratio of Ram and Robert? It is 7:3. Now, Rahim admitted as a new partner. Who is admitted as a new partner? Rahim is admitted as a new partner. Ram and Robert decided to surrender in favor of Rahim 1/7 and 1/3 of their share respectively. Calculate new profit sharing ratio of the all the partners. Calculate the new profit sharing ratio of all the partners. Now here, the situation is a little bit different. Again, we will understand with an example. Like here, Ram and Robert, what is their profit sharing ratio, children? 7:3. How we will write that in fraction? It is 7 by 10 and 3 by 10. Okay, that means out of 10 parts, 7 parts are given to Ram and 3 parts are given to Robert. Okay, so Ram, it is 7 by 10 and Robert, it is 3 by 10. This is their old profit sharing ratio. Now, Rahim is a new partner who is admitted into the business and now we have to calculate his new profit sharing ratio. How to calculate? Ram is surrendering 1/7 ratio of profit to Rahim. That means Ram is going to sacrifice some part, some share. Okay, Ram, how much he is sacrificing? Out of 7 by 10, he is sacrificing 1/7 of 7 by 10. Okay, he is sacrificing 1/7 of 7 by 10. Okay, so what he is sacrificing, his sacrifice, and what Robert is sacrificing, he is sacrificing 1/3 of 3 by 10. Okay. Whatever Ram and Robert is sacrificing will be a gaining. That means his new profit ratio of Ram will be their sacrificing ratio. Here, in the you may get confused, like teacher, in the previous example also, Rahim has given something, Ram has given something, we have seen, no? Like he purchased some share, but here he is not purchasing. Here Rahim's new profit sharing ratio is not given in the question. No, we have to calculate his new profit sharing ratio. Okay, so Ram is surrendering from his ratio 1/7 part to Rahim, and Robert is surrendering 1/3 part from his share to Rahim. So first we need to calculate what is the sacrificing ratio of Ram and Robert. Okay, so Ram's sacrificing ratio, what is it? It is 1/7 part of 7/10. 7/10, out of 7/10, this is Ram's old sacrificing ratio. Out of 7/10, Ram is sacrificing 1/7 part. That is equal to 1/7 into 7/10. That is equal to 1/10. So how much Ram is sacrificing his ratio to the new partner? It is 1/10. Out of his share, 1/10 share is sacrificed by Ram. Now, how much Robert is sacrificing? 1/3 of 3/10. Okay, from his 3/10, he is sacrificing 1/3 part. That is 1/10 he is sacrificing. Okay, so new profit sharing ratio of Ram is equal to old ratio minus sacrificing ratio. So whatever Ram's old ratio is there, we have to minus how much he is sacrificing. Then we will get his new profit sharing ratio. Like Ram's old profit sharing ratio is 7/10. How much he is sacrificing? He is sacrificing 1/10. Okay, 1/10. So his new profit sharing ratio is equal to 6/10. Here already denominator is the same. So directly you can write 10, and 7 minus 1 is equal to 6. So 6/10 is the new profit sharing ratio of Ram. In the same way, we have to calculate new profit sharing ratio for Robert also. So Robert's new profit sharing ratio is old ratio minus sacrificing ratio. What is his old ratio? His old ratio is 3/10. So 3/10 minus 1/10 is equal to 2/10. Here denominator is the same. So you will take as it is. 3 minus 1, it's 2. So when you take LCM, children, when the denominators are not same, then you should go for LCM. Okay. So 3 minus 1 is equal to 2/10. So Ram's new profit sharing ratio is 6/10, and Robert's new profit sharing ratio is 2/10. Then what is Rahim's share of profit? What I told, whatever Ram is sacrificing, whatever Robert is sacrificing, that will be Rahim's share. Yes or no? If one is losing something, the other will be gaining. Yes or no? If they are losing their 1/10 share, 1/10 share, Robert is losing, Ram is losing 1/10 share. So their lose, whatever they are losing, will be his gain. So his profit sharing ratio, that will be his profit sharing ratio. So Rahim's share of profit, how we'll get? His sacrificing ratio, that is 1/10. Robert's sacrificing ratio, that is 1/10. That is equal to 2/10. Here as the denominators are the same, no need to take LCM. So directly you will take 10, and 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. 2/10 is Rahim's share of profit. So new profit sharing ratio of Ram, Robert and Rahim is 6/10 is to 2/10 is to 2/10, or 6 is to 2 is to 2, or 3 is to, if we still reduce the value, it is 3 is to 1 is to 1. Okay, children. So this is the third scenario, how to calculate new profit sharing ratio. So one thing what you need to understand, whenever a new partner is admitted into the business, definitely in any situation, the profit sharing ratio of the partners will be changing. So we have to calculate the new profit sharing ratio. Okay. Now see ratio of sacrifice. Okay. What is the ratio of sacrifice? When a new partner is admitted into the partnership, already in the previous slide also we have seen, no, what is the ratio of how to calculate also we have seen. So here ratio of sacrifice, when a new partner is admitted into partnership business, the old partners forego a fraction of their share of profit in the favor of the new partner, and thus reducing the share of profit and loss of the old partners. Yes or no? If a new partner is admitted, they are foregoing. That means they are losing their share. Whatever they are losing is benefiting to whom? It is benefiting to the new partner. Okay, this also we'll understand again with a example. So ratio of sacrifice, what is the formula children for ratio of sacrifice? Old profit sharing ratio minus new profit sharing ratio. Okay, so whenever old partners sacrifice, new partner will gain. Yes or no? Before admitting yes, what G and Y are doing? They were enjoying this full cake, but when they admitted yes, they are giving some part to S. So whatever they are sacrificing will be new partner's gain or new partner's new profit sharing ratio. Okay, so their sacrifice will be her gaining ratio. Is it clear, children? Now we will understand this with an example. Ganga and Yamuna are partners sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 3:2. They admitted Saraswati as new partner. Hereafter, they share profits and losses in the ratio of 4:3:2 by Ganga, Yamuna and Saraswati respectively. Calculate the ratio of sacrifice. It is very easy, no? Now we know their old profit sharing ratio and we know their new profit sharing ratio. So how we'll get the ratio of sacrifice? The old profit sharing ratio of Ganga, Yamuna and Saraswati is 3:2. That is 3/5:2/5. And the new profit sharing ratio of Ganga, Yamuna and Saraswati is 4/9, 3/9, 2/9 respectively. How we are getting this 9? You have to add this all. 4+3+2. 4+3, 7. 7+2, 9. That means out of 9 parts, 4 parts are given to Ganga, 3 parts are given to Yamuna, and Saraswati will be getting 2 parts. So their old profit sharing ratio is 3:2. Their new profit sharing ratio is 4:3:2. Now it is very easy for us to calculate ratio of sacrifice. Now what is the formula for ratio of sacrifice? It is old ratio minus new ratio. So we know their old ratio and we know their new ratio. It is given in the question. Now it is very easy for us to calculate their sacrificing ratio. So for Ganga, old ratio is 3:2, that is 3/5. And the new ratio of Ganga is 4:3:2, 4/9. So we have to take LCM. 5, 9, what is the, these are denominators are not the same. So we are taking LCM. 5, 9, LCM is 45. 5, how many times it will go? 9. So 9 × 3, 27. 9, 5 times it will go, 45. 5 × 4, 20. So 27 − 20/45 = 7/45. Now, same way we have to calculate ratio of sacrifice. So how much sacrifice Yamuna is doing? Oh, that is 2/5 − 3/9. How we are getting? 5/9, you have to take LCM, that is 45. 5, how many times it will go in 45? It will go 9 times. 9 × 2, how much? 18. Minus 9, how many times it will go in 45? It is 5 times. 5 × 3 = 15. So 18 − 15 = 18 − 15/45. That is equal to 3/45. So Yamuna is sacrificing 3/45 share and Ganga is sacrificing 7/45 share. So the ratio of sacrifice between Ganga and Yamuna is 7:3. Okay, respectively. Loss to old partners Ganga and Yamuna is gain to new partner Saraswati. That is 7/45 + 3/45. That is equal to 10/45. That is, when we reduce, it comes to 2/9. See, already this 2/9 is given in the question, but to understand again by solving also, we are showing you. Like already it is given you, new profit sharing ratio is 4:3:2. That is 2/9. It is given already in the question. How we get this 2/9? Whatever sacrifice is done by Ganga and Yamuna, if we add that sacrifices, what they have done will be the new profit sharing ratio of Saraswati. Okay, so their loss is Saraswati's gain. This is how we calculate ratio of sacrifice, children. In the next thing, we have seen whenever a new partner is admitted, that the new profit sharing ratio should be calculated. So we have seen, see how when a partner is admitted, what are the different scenarios in which we calculate new profit sharing ratio. Next, I told we have to revalue the assets and liabilities also. No, that means whatever assets and liabilities are there in the business, we have to revalue, bring out their value, because let us suppose they started the business 10 years back. They purchased land, building, furniture, whatever is there 10 years back. The value will not be the same, no, till date. They have to revalue it. Whatever profit or loss they are going to get, they have to write somewhere, no? That is, they will write in the revaluation account. Okay. So when the new partner is admitted, it becomes necessary to revalue the assets and liabilities of the firm in order to ascertain their true values, to show the true value of the asset. If the value of asset has decreased, we have to show the same thing. If the value of asset is increased, we have to show the same thing whenever a new partner is admitted. Okay. So if we show the true values, then what happens? Okay. The new partner, he should not be benefited or he should not suffer from any appreciation or depreciation in the value of assets and liabilities. So if the value of asset is appreciating, that is increasing, or depreciating, that is decreasing, that should not affect the new partner. Okay. He should not benefit or he should not suffer anything like loss or profit, whatever it is. He should not benefit or suffer. So what we need to do? We need to revalue it. When we revalue, we have to write somewhere, no? We have to make a note of it. So where we make the note of all the changes of the values of assets and liabilities, we record in a revaluation account. Okay, this revaluation account will have a rule of a nominal account because it is a nominal account only. So you all know, no, what are the rule for first year? You already have studied rule for nominal account. Debit all expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gains. So whatever rule is there for nominal account, same rule will be applying for revaluation account also. So whatever expenses and losses are there, you have to write on the debit side. And if at all any incomes and gains are there, you have to write on the credit side of the revaluation account, children. Because this is mean when we solve the problems, you have to do the revaluation account. So we are discussing here and we will see one specimen account also, ledger account of revaluation account also, so that you will get an idea. Again, we will discuss in depth when we do problems. Okay. So this is a specimen of revaluation account, children. Whenever we are valuing the assets, we do the revalue of the assets. The changes, whatever happened with that asset, we will be recording in this revaluation account. How to record? Just I'll give an example. When we do problems in detail, we will discuss. Suppose there is a furniture purchased for rupees 10,000. Furniture is purchased for 10,000. Now they are telling the furniture is valued at 8,000. Okay. The furniture is purchased for 10,000, but now it is valued at 8,000. That means what is happening for the value of that asset? It is decreasing or increasing? It is decreasing. By how much value it is decreasing? By 2,000. Yes or no? It was 10,000. Now it is 8,000. The how much value it is decreasing? 2,000. Okay. So whenever there is a decrease in the value of an asset, you have to write on the debit side, because decrease means it is a loss, no? Value of an asset we purchased for 10,000. Now its value is 8,000. That means it is decreased by 2,000 rupees. So that 2,000 is a loss expense. It is a loss for the company, no? So you have to write on the debit side of the revaluation account. You have to write on the debit side of the revaluation account. Whenever a value of an asset decreases, you have to write on the debit side. If the same thing, the value of an asset increases, then you have to write on the credit side. For example, if you take land, land value always appreciates. It never depreciates. Yes or no? Land value, if we are purchasing for 10,000, it will not be 10,000. No. So let us say they have purchased the land for rupees 10,000 and it is valued now before admitting a partner at 20,000. Now, how much the value of that asset increased, children? It has been increased by 10,000 rupees. Yes or no? When we purchased, it was 10,000. When the old partners purchased, it was 10,000. Now it is 20,000. How much it is increased? It is increased by 10,000 rupees. So whenever there is an increase in the value of an asset, you have to write on the credit side of the revaluation account because it is a gain. Okay. So you have to write on the credit side of the revaluation account. Vice versa happens with liabilities. Okay. When asset is decreasing, we are writing on the debit side. No, vice versa happens with the liability. If a liability increases, then you have to write on the debit side. If the liability decreases, then you have to write on the credit side. See, for example, there are creditors, 5,000 worth creditors. Now, it is mentioned in the question, 2,000 creditors are not to be recorded. That means your liability has been decreased, no? It has been decreased by 2,000 rupees. So that you need to write on the credit side of the revaluation account. Okay, we will discuss in depth, children, when we solve the problem. Just what you need to understand here is, when asset value increases, we write on the debit side. When the asset value decreases, we write on the debit side. When the asset value increases, we write on the credit side of the revaluation account. Vice versa happens with the liability. When the liability value increases, we write on the debit side. And when the liability value decreases, we write on the credit side of the revaluation account. In the same way, provision for bad debts is also an expense. So that should be written down on the debit side of the revaluation account. If they say no provision should be created for bad debts, so you will be writing on the credit side. So whatever balancing figure will be your profit or loss. If your credit side total is more, the balancing figure will be your profit. If your debit side total is more, that is, if your expenses are more, then your credit side balancing figure will be your loss. Okay. So revaluation account. So whenever a new partner is admitted into the partnership firm, we have to calculate the new profit sharing ratio, because the new profit sharing ratio of the partners will be changing. So that we have seen how to calculate in three different scenarios. Next, the assets and liabilities value should be revalued. So that value, whatever it is changing, we have to make a note somewhere, no? That we are recording in the revaluation account. So what rule we follow for revaluation account? The rule of nominal account only we will follow for revaluation account. If the value of an asset decreases, you have to write on the debit side. If the value of an asset increases, you have to write on credit side. If the liability increases, you have to write on the debit side. If the liability decreases, you have to write on the credit side of the revaluation account. So whatever profit we get out of this revaluation account should be transferred to old partners only, because here new partner is no way related, no? These all assets, liabilities, all relate to old partners only. So whatever profit or loss they get in revaluation account should be transferred to old partners' capital accounts in their old profit sharing ratio. Okay. Just you be acquainted with the terminology, whatever I'm using, children, here, because first time when you are listening, you may feel it little bit difficult. But when you start solving the problems, you will be acquainted with the solutions and the terminology, and you will understand the concepts also. Just to make you familiar before solving the problems, to make you people familiar with all the terminology and all the understanding, just I'm giving a hint for you, children. Okay, don't get panic if you people feel, oh, it's we are not able to follow you. Okay, once again, you go through the video. It will be very easy for you. If you understand, I'm saying this will be the best, easiest chapter. You can easily score 20 marks if you understand the chapter. Okay, so we have seen how to calculate profit sharing ratios and even revaluation account, that is revaluing assets and liabilities. And adjustment of accumulated profits and losses and reserves. What I told, this also need to be changed, you know. These are the profits and losses and reserves. These all belong to old partners. So they didn't they kept some reserve from profits. All these years they have kept some amount aside, so that if any unforeseen contingencies happen or any uncertainty happen in the future, so that they can use that amount. Now, before admitting a new partner, they have to distribute this among themselves, no? So that all changes also we have to do whenever a new partner is admitted into the business. Okay, general reserve account always shows a credit balance, hence it appears on liability side of balance sheet. Okay, in the closing balance sheet, if at all general reserve account is given, then only we will prepare this account. If not, no need to prepare. Okay, so it shows a credit balance, so it is always appears on the liability side of the balance sheet. Okay, the balance of undistributed profits show a credit balance, thus it also appears on the liability side of the balance sheet. If there is any undistributed loss, it shows debit balance, thus appears on the asset side of the balance sheet. Okay, in the closing balance, where you find this general reserve and the profit and loss account, children, you will find in the balance sheet on the liability side, because they show the credit balance. Undistributed profit shows a credit balance, so it will be in the closing balance liability side. Even general reserve also will be seen on the balance sheet liability side. If at all any loss, you will see in the asset side of the balance sheet. This we have to transfer to old partners in their old profit sharing ratio. This also we will understand when we try to solve the problems. There we will see general reserve account, profit and loss account, how to transfer to old partners in their old profit sharing ratio. Okay, general reserve and balance of profit and loss account both belong to old partners. Hence, they are to be transferred to old partners' capital or current accounts in their old profit sharing ratio. So this we will understand while doing problems in detail. Okay, simple. What you need to keep in mind here, don't get panic, just keep in mind that whatever general reserve or profit and loss is given in the closing balance sheet, that amount should be transferred to old partners, because that amount is old partners' amount. New partner is no way concerned with that amount. So before admitting new partner, whatever amount, balance amount is there, that should be transferred to old partners' capital account in their old profit sharing ratio. Is it clear, children? So this is one adjustment. Okay, next, goodwill and accounting treatment. So what is goodwill? We have seen. Okay, we understood in the first slide. Now, what is goodwill? Goodwill refers to the reputation of the business of the enterprise. Okay, the valuation of goodwill depends upon many factors. Already we discussed the nature of the business, the size of the business, then the customer satisfaction, their reputation. Okay, everything. Many factors are involved whenever we say the value of goodwill, how it is valued. Okay, so now we will see what are the features of goodwill. It is intangible asset. Goodwill is an intangible asset. What do you mean by intangible here? It doesn't have any form. We cannot see it. We cannot touch it. But we can experience it, no? We can experience. Like whatever goodwill is there, we can enjoy the fruits. We cannot see it. We cannot touch it. But we can enjoy. We can experience the goodwill. Okay? So that is an intangible asset. Next, it is value depends on various factors. Already I told you what are the different various factors on which the value of goodwill depends. It's like its future earnings, the quality of the product, next, their service, their efficient management, their size, their nature, customer satisfaction, their brand, everything. On many factors, the value of goodwill depends. Okay. Next, it generates more profits. When we have goodwill, the company or the firm will be generating more profits than normal profits. If the company is not having goodwill, maybe it has normal profits. If the company's goodwill is good, it may be generating more and more profits than normal profits. Okay. It is inseparable. That means you cannot separate goodwill from business. It coexists with the business. It goes along with the business. So you cannot separate business and goodwill. It is inseparable. It goes along with the business. It exists with the business. Okay. You cannot see it. You cannot touch it. But you can get its fruits. You can experience it. Okay. So these are the features of goodwill, children. Now, circumstances under which the valuation of goodwill takes place. So when we calculate goodwill, whenever profit sharing ratio is changed, then the valuation of goodwill takes place. When two firms amalgamate or merge, they come together, then also we calculate goodwill. Whenever a partner is admitted into the business, then also goodwill is valued. Firm is dissolved and sold to a company. Whenever we are going to sell any company, how much goodwill should be brought, or how much is the goodwill? That valuation will be done in all the circumstances. We have to do this valuation of goodwill in all the circumstances. It takes place whenever a partner retires or dies. Whenever a partner retires or he will die, then also we have to value the goodwill children. Now, methods of valuation of goodwill. We have three methods. First one is average profit method. Here, what they do, the under this method, average profits of last few years is ascertained, and thereafter the average profit is multiplied by an agreed number of years purchase. Okay, now we go with an example though, so that it will be easy for you to understand. For example, let us take the net profit of the company for 4 years. Last 4 years is 40,000, 38,000, 50,000 and 52,000. This is the profit. So now how you will get the average profit? When you divide by number of years, how many years is there? 1, 2, 3, 4 years. If you divide by 4, you will get average profit. So that average profit, the goodwill is to be taken as 2 years purchase of average profit. Whatever average profit you are getting, for that 2 years purchase you have to take. Okay. So we will see how to calculate. So average profit is equal to how you will get average profit, total profit of last 4 years divided by 4 years. That is 40,000, 38,000, 50, 52 divided by 4. So how many years? 1, 2, 3, 4. So that many number of years, if you divide, you will get average. That is 45,000 is the average profit of the firm. Now, this average profit into 2 years of purchase, they are telling in the question. That means you have to multiply with 2. With this average profit, then you will get your goodwill. So the value of goodwill is 19,000. So this is average profit method. How to calculate goodwill? That is how to value goodwill. We are now making a value. In the previous, I told, okay, he will be bringing goodwill, 30,000, 20,000, whatever amount I'm telling. But how that 30, 20, we have to fix it. How we have to calculate it? One method is average profit method. In this method, total average of the profits is taken. In the question, they will be mentioning whether it is 4 years, 5 years. So that average profit into 2 years purchase, then you will be getting average profit. So this is average profit method to value goodwill. Now in the second method is super profit method. We have to value goodwill in super profit method. So under this method, super profit is calculated by deducting the normal profit or expected profit on capital employed from the actual average profit of the last few years by multiply the agreed number of years. So now we will understand this also with an example, children. If you read the theory, it will be difficult for you people to understand. Here is an example. The normal rate of return on the capital employed in the industry is 20%. The investment or capital employed in the firm is 2 lakhs. It's not 2,000. Correct it. It is 2 lakhs. Actual average profit of the firm is rupees 60,000. Goodwill of the firm is valued at 4 years purchase of super profit. Calculate the value of goodwill. Here you have capital employed. It is 20%. Return on capital employed is 20%. What is capital employed? It is 2 lakhs. And they have given actual average profit also. That is 60,000. So you have to calculate goodwill of the firm valued at 4 years of purchase of super profit. So here what information is given in the question? Capital employed is 2 lakhs. Rate of return on profit on capital employed is 20%. Actual average profit is 60,000. It is given in the question. Now you have to, first out of this, you have to calculate normal profit. How you will get normal profit? Capital employed into return. 20% is the return they are telling. So capital employed is 2 lakhs into 20 by 100. So 40,000 is your normal profit. They have given actual average profit. You have calculated normal profit. Now super profit. How you will get super profit? What is the formula for super profit? Actual average profit minus normal profit. What is the actual average profit? It is 60,000 minus what is your normal profit? It is 40,000. So 20,000 is your super profit. So what is the formula for super profit? You have to actual average profit minus normal profit. So average profit they have given in the question. We have calculated normal profit. How we got this normal profit? Capital employed, they have given, that is capital is 2 lakhs, on that returns is 20%. So 40,000 is our returns. So actual average profit minus normal profit. So 60,000 minus 40,000, 20,000 is super profit. So how you will calculate goodwill? What they told? Super profit into 4 years of purchase they told. Yes. So super profit into 4. That is, what is super profit? 20,000 into 4, that is 80,000. So value of goodwill is 80,000. What is this method, children? This is super profit method. First we have seen average profit method. This is super profit method. Third method of calculating goodwill is capitalization of profit method. Under this method, the value of goodwill is ascertained by capitalization of average profits and super profits. Okay. Now, till now, what we have learned, children? We have discussed about need for admission of a partner whenever the old partners want to increase their capital or they want the managerial skills of the new admission of a new partner, or both, they want to admit a new partner to expand their business. Next, what we discussed? We discussed the calculation of new profit sharing ratio in three different situations. How to calculate new profit sharing ratio, we have discussed. Again, we have discussed even calculation of sacrificing ratio also. So whatever sacrificing ratio of old partners is there, that will be the gaining ratio for new partner. Even we discussed about revaluation of assets and liabilities. Whatever value, the change in the value of assets and liabilities, we have to record in revaluation account. So we have even seen the specimen of revaluation account also. Okay. And even we discussed about adjustment of accumulated profits that and losses and reserves, that is general reserve, that all should be transferred to old partners in their old profit sharing ratio, because this amount belongs to old partners. New partner is no way concerned with this amount. So this undistributed profits or general reserve, whatever is there in the books, that should be transferred to old partners in their old profit sharing ratio. And even we discussed what is goodwill and what are the features of goodwill. And even we discussed methods of valuation of goodwill. What are the three different methods, children? Average profit method, super profit method, and capitalization of profit method. The three methods also we have seen valuation of goodwill. After this discussion, I think you will be in a position, children, to solve two small problems which will be given. It will be easy. If at all you have any doubt, you go through the slides explanation, then come back and you discuss, you try to solve the problems, children. I have given two problems here. Already we discussed these two problems in the previous slides, situations, that is calculation of new profit sharing ratio. Try to solve it, because calculation of new profit sharing ratio, you will be getting for 2 marks in the final exam. So if you have any doubts, still go through again the video, then come back and try to solve this problem. After 2 days, we will upload the solution in the comment box, children. Is it clear? In the next session, we are going to have a session on problem solving, how to solve problems in admission of a partner. So what I want you people is, when you come for that session, I want you people to carry textbooks with you. When you keep textbook with you, and I refer the page number and question, when you go through the question, if you keep the textbook in front of you and go through the question, it will be very easy for you to understand. Without having textbook and understanding, it is very difficult. If you don't have textbook, like you are not issued with a textbook, then at least have a book and pen with you, so that whatever important points I tell you to note down, you just make a note. So while discussing, it will be easy for you people to understand. Is it clear, children? Stay home, stay safe, stay productive, stay connected. And thank you. Thank you one and all. And I thank our principal ma'am, Shailaja madam, for giving me this opportunity. And even special thanks to our subject coordinator, principal sir, Riyazuddin sir, principal Jarasangam. Thank you. Thank you, one and all.
Hello. Thank you, Prevlata. Thank you for introducing admission of a partner. And children, I hope this was a enlightening session. Very important topic madam has covered today. Solve the problems. And as madam said, the second session will be problem solving session. So if you understand the concept very well and solve the basic problems that are given today, and if you go through the solutions that will be uploaded after 2 days, then if you once again cross check with that, then you can go for the second session, what madam will be telling in the next session. Okay, so revisit this session once again, make the note of important points, understand, have a wholesome knowledge of the concept of admission of partner. Very important. It will be important in your higher education also. Thank you. Thank you, Premlata madam.
Thank you.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you.